My name's Tracy. My friends call me Katie. Katie! You see, I had a dream. I wanted to become an actress. I love the theatre. Kate Winslet! Yes, Titanic. I dreamt this dream at Brig House School. I started there when I was 4. It helped to make me who I am. It was my hero. And what happened to my school is what the play's all about. We had lots of fun. I bet other schools don't have wheelchair races. We even had a swimming pool. I called it our duck pond. Most of my pals had health problems. Cerebral palsy like Pete. Spina bifida like Jessie. Cystic fibrosis like me. You need a medical dictionary here. All sorts of things. Speech problems, Crohn's, brittle bones. My friend, Tommy Dixon, died. He was only 13. The whole school was in mourning when he died. It was so sad. Some people didn't like an all-age school, but it worked. Let me tell you about some of the people I loved. Our school nurse, Babs. She was always kept pretty busy. Our physio, Bunty. She used to massage my legs between lessons. It was lovely. Some of my pals got help with speech and language. John Errington, he taught me English. He gave me my love of drama. He once took me to the RSC. That's what gave me my dream of going on the stage. And I love singing. I sang Annie. You know. Tomorrow, tomorrow, I love you tomorrow. That's why I liked our music lessons. We had a wonderful teacher, Emma, Caribbean Sunshine. Oh, I almost forgot, our head teacher, Margaret Williamson. In my diary, I call her Mummy Margaret. You see, we were one great big family. Our motto was all for one. She really cared about each one of us. I loved our ethos, when John explained to me what the word meant. All sorts of people gave their time to the school, especially our mums and dads. They campaigned to keep the school open. I was in Westboro's amateur dramatics. John Errington, he encouraged me to join. I thought they wouldn't want me. Oh, and I must tell you about our band, our fantastic steel drum band. I played in it. We seemed to be performing somewhere every other week. Despite all this, some people wanted to close us down. They thought we should all go to mainstream schools. I wanted to stay at Brig House. Our mums and dads asked me to help their campaign to keep the school open. I even went on the telly. I did. Those people thought they were helping us, putting us into mainstream schools. I often used to wonder whether they really understood what it was like to have serious health problems and not find learning easy on top of that. And did they begin to understand what it was like to be bullied on top of everything else? Did they? Most kids like us have forever been bullied in mainstream schools. Did they know? And did they know what it was like for their mums too, when they came back home? I know what it's like. I saw Fluff, my pussycat, after a little boy tossed a bucket of water all over her, just for a bit of fun. I tell you something, lawyers and politicians just love to give us our rights. Rights. I call them buttercups and daisies. And we are those little white dandelion heads. You know, they blow away in the wind.
What is going to happen to this school? I don't want Harry to come here if they're going to close it.
The LEA said it could happen.
Well, they certainly did want it to. Until our parents persuaded them not to. It was some campaign. They didn't know what hit them.
I read all about it in the local papers.
Well, they had been warned. They held a meeting here to sell mainstream schools to our parents. At the end of the meeting, all the parents, every single one of them, put up their hands to say they didn't agree. Well, they just went ahead anyway.
I thought they were supposed to listen to parents.
Well, you read what happened in the press. The minister stopped the closure plan.
So how does it stand now?
As I said, the minister threw out the closure plan. You know, if they ever close this school, it'll break my heart. But if they close us down, it'll be over my dead body.
Unfortunately, there were people that wanted to do just that. Close our school. At about the same time we were having our music lesson, four of them were meeting up at the regional office of the Department for Education and Skills. I call them the Execution Squad. They thought that they were right. A lot of people did. And probably still do. Let's get back to Brick House School, shall we? You'll remember that Mummy Margaret said she liked to stretch us. She said that some of us even went abseiling. Well, I was one of them. I was so scared at the time. I had butterflies in my tummy the size of pomegranates. Jean told me to sing on the way down. Tomorrow, tomorrow, I love you tomorrow. All my pals cried out, Katie, Katie, Katie. Well, I tell you something, next summer I'm going paragliding in Wales. Anyway, they stretched us, but we stretched them. I haven't told you about our carer, Wendy. We called her Poo Bar. You see, she used to take some of us to the loo. We were sometimes closer to her than to our teachers. Let's go back to our music lessons. Emma, Caribbean Sunshine, was a wonderful teacher. She'd have been a great gospel singer in the Caribbean.
Our last lesson was all about mood and atmosphere, created by music or captured in music. Can any of you remember any of it?
Mars God of War.
Trust you to remember that one, Terry. I remember Winter from the Four Seasons. It gave me the shivers.
Who was it by?
Vivaldi.
Good! Both of you! I'm really going to open up your eardrums this fine morning. The music I shall play for you today will reach parts of you that well-known beer won't reach.
Give me one.
Oh, shut up, Terry.
I'm talking about the thing that separates the human race from the animal kingdom. Music.
Birds sing.
They're the exception that proves the rule. Wouldn't the world be awful if they didn't?
Awful.
Anyway, I'm talking today about the spiritual side of music. The spirit of God is in this music, or simply the human spirit. Call it either. In my book, they are the same thing. It's the music of joy and the music of sadness. Discord as well as harmony carries the beat of life itself. We are going to start with harmony. You see, the great thing about music is that it has no boundaries. It's universal. Listen to this.
Our country will become whatever. Music knows no boundaries. Music knows no boundaries.
Our country will become whatever.
Music knows no boundaries. Music knows no boundaries.
Our country will become whatever.
Music knows no boundaries. Music knows no
sadness.
Music knows no
with forgiveness.
Music knows no boundaries.
Those guys won two Grammys and performed at two Nobel Peace Prize ceremonies. That music comes out of South Africa. But if you want to find your God, if there is a God, listen to good music from anywhere in the big wide world.
I register a protest on behalf of the parents and the governors.
That will be for them, Margaret, but you'll go along with us.
We'll not give you
satisfaction of thinking you've persuaded me. I will not... But I'll go along with you, all right? The next evening, Mummy Margaret tried to kill herself. I'll never forget the next day. Not ever. The whole school was in mourning. I've never seen everyone look so sad. It was awful. Awful. It must have been terrible for her. We still didn't know whether our head teacher was okay or not. There was a rumour. It had something to do with closing our school. Emma gave us all a hug. She said she was praying every minute of the day for our head teacher. Terry went home. He was sick all over the place. Wendy had to clear up the mess. And me? Well, I was all weepy and didn't feel like learning much at all. That day, someone trod on my dreams. Mr. Smithson took over his head. We were told until Mummy Margaret was well enough to come back. I call him Daddy Longlegs in my diary. It was amazing how quickly our lessons got back to normal. I'm afraid the good times didn't last. There turned out to be truth in the rumour that our music teacher was going to be leaving us. And worse, there might be a full-time music teacher taking her place. And there was another rumour. The LEA still wanted to close us down. I've still got the letter I wrote to the Prime Minister. I thought I could make it a special wheelchair delivery to Downing Street, but I just posted it. Jean said she'd make a new story out of it in the Gazette. Even got a little write-up in there. Dear Prime Minister, I am writing to invite you to visit my school. I am writing to you personally because you should know what pupils like me think about where we should be taught. I know that some love the challenge of a mainstream school. We think we'll be a lot better off here, learning more and enjoying our school days as well. You should see for yourself just how much we will lose if this school is closed. My parents said this could still happen, even though all our parents said they wanted it kept open. My childhood was a happy one, but difficult at the same time. When you're in a wheelchair and all your friends have been walking, straight away it clicks you're different. I first went to primary school, but I was called Old Wheelie Bin there, and that was not very pleasant. Some of my friends were called Spackers. But then I came here to Brick House. They gave me real enthusiasm for living. Brick House does not take or give the easy option. It pushes everyone to the full and then pushes some more. It pushed me academically and physically, even though I'm in a wheelchair. Some of my pals have competed in Great North Runs and in the Athens Paralympics. One won a silver medal there, and another a gold. And I am planning on getting my GCSEs and word processing qualifications. I also play in the Timpan Alley Steel Drum Band. We have gigs every week and give a lot of pleasure to a lot of people, especially to ourselves. Children like me do not wish to be social experiments. We have got one chance, and the staff here know how to make it a real one. If you could just spare the time to come down to our school and look into the eyes of the children and ask them where they want to be, I personally guarantee you won't want us to go anywhere else. I may not be a voter today, but I soon will be. Yours sincerely, Tracy Jones. I got a long letter back, not from the Prime Minister. We wouldn't lose out. Our parents would be fully consulted, da-da-da-da-da. You know, In Downing Street, that's the one thing the faceless ones are very good at. Writing letters. The terrible cloud over the school began to lift a little. Mummy Margaret had gone round. It didn't lift altogether, though. Not for anyone. I've tried to understand it. Why do some people like to destroy things that are beautiful? They do. They really do. Some are just out and out vandals. What they can't have, they don't want anyone else to have. And others? Maybe it's because they think that what's right for them is right for everyone else, when it just isn't. And then they go on to think that everything else is wrong. If that is the reason, they make a big mistake. I mean, when you think about it, isn't it a bit arrogant? A bit blinkered? Aren't they, how do you say, just too clever by half? Certainly too clever for our good. I mean, it's not as though they've always got it right for the kids that want to go to mainstream schools. And there are some. Somebody should tell them. Trouble is, they think they understand us when they just don't. And they don't understand what they are stealing from some of us either. The rest of this play's history. It started with a meeting with the parents and the execution squad. I wasn't invited. Well, it had to happen, didn't it? It was about a year later. Have you ever seen a bulldozer at work? You must have. And have you heard it clanking and grinding? I still can. One moment, a building is there. The next, it's a pile of rubble. Just rubble. And we watched it all happen. I won't forget it. I lost part of myself that day. That bulldozer, well, for me, it was sort of symbolic. You see, we were all casualties one way or another. Remember the name my friends called me? Katie, after Kate Winslet. I was on the Titanic too.
You're still gonna sing her praises on Sunday?
Sure I am. She knows how I feel. It's just she's got some catching up to do.
Emma, you really don't have to bring God into it.
I do bring God into it. I just fear for her temper these days. One way or another, I think we're really provoking her. She's capable of quite a tantrum when she's provoked. We'd better be a little more careful with ourselves and stop provoking her.
In about a year's time, there'll be some lovely houses here.
Mine's the one with the duck pond.
It's rubble. Just rubble. Such a pity.
Memories. Just memories.
Come on, you guys. Join me like old times. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are grey. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine.
Well, a couple of weeks ago, in the next street to mine. A boy of 12. I think he was a bit overweight. Well, he tried to take his own life. Thank you for coming to listen to my story. Can I leave you with a really naughty thought to take home with you? There are some little creatures that build and defend their own nests, but they cannot move on and they cannot do anything else. That's what they do. They build and defend their own nests. That's all they do. That's all they've ever done. And that's all they'll ever do. There is a name for them. Termites. Yes, termites. If there are any of them here tonight, let them go to their beds and sleep peacefully. If they can. You see, I'm not just going to blow away in the wind. Good night.